Today we're by the River Otter in Devon, next to a newly planted woodland that was planted through the Countryside Stewardship Woodland Creation Grant. It's about 10 hectares in size. Through Countryside Stewardship there are a couple of main reasons for biodiversity and for water why we encourage people to plant woodland, but one of the more generic reasons that we strongly encourage woodland planting is to try and fight climate change. One of the main reasons why we're suffering climate change and global warming at the moment are the increased levels of CO2 and carbon in the atmosphere, and trees are a fantastic way of taking that carbon back out of the atmosphere. They use the carbon to grow, so they put that carbon into trunks and into branches and into leaves. One of the best ways they do it is by us planting diverse mixes of trees. So we really like people, if they're going to plant woodland, to plant a broad range of tree species. Research has shown that at a forest level, woodlands with lots of different species of trees will sequester carbon at a better rate more efficiently than if you just have a narrow band and big clumps of single species plantations. So good species mix is a good thing. It's also a good thing from another point of view, in that it makes woodlands more resilient. So with lots of tree diseases around at the moment, things like ash dieback and Dutch elm disease, actually if we plant single species in big clumps and a disease comes along that hits those species hard, we're in real trouble. So planting a good species mix will hopefully make our woodlands more resilient and help them sequester carbon at a quicker rate. One of the main reasons we plant through Countryside Stewardship is to improve water, so to help with natural flood management and to reduce issues of erosion around watercourses, nutrient enrichment of rivers and water bodies. Trees are a fantastic way of helping with natural flood management. They do this in a number of ways. One of the ways is they simply reduce the rate that water from the sky hits the ground. Water stays on leaves, stays on the trunk. It actually just takes a lot longer, so you reduce that sort of flash flood effect that you get when, say, water lands on concrete or completely bare ground. Trees will also massively increase the rate that water can actually infiltrate through the soil. So a study in Wales showed that underneath broadleaf trees, water can infiltrate into the soil about 67 times faster than on a very short grazed grassland area. So that's a massive effect in terms of the water going down into the soil rather than just hitting the soil and then running off into the slopes. The other way that it really helps is just by providing a bit of structure. So it literally provides what's known as sort of a rougher perimeter. So it physically takes longer for water to access the point where it falls and get into the watercourse, just because it's not going in a straight line. It has other things to work its way around. So lots of ways that trees help, and especially when planting near to watercourses, broadleafs allow a bit of light in. So when you're thinking about what species you're going to plant directly near to watercourses, we'd certainly encourage planting broadleafs closer to the watercourse, but conifers can still have that reduced rate of water runoff further away from the water's edge without causing too much shading. So aside from the benefits of natural flood management and carbon storage that we are really encouraging through Countryside Stewardship Woodland Creation Grant, there are a number of benefits directly for the farmer. So things like reducing erosion and reducing soil runoff from your field means that you're losing less of that valuable soil to grow crops in the future. So trees can really help with preventing that loss of soil into watercourses and ultimately out to sea. Also through Countryside Stewardship, you can plant as little as 1 hectare in blocks as small as 0.1 of a hectare, and that can prove really useful for a number of farmers where you have marginal areas, so small field corners, awkward slopes where it's really difficult to farm the land and to grow anything else. Planting woodland in those places can really solve a problem for the landowner whilst also delivering good benefits through natural flood management. Obviously, of course, if you're planting trees, that's still potentially a commercial crop. So thinning's especially a good way of making a small income through firewood sales.